بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وصلى الله على النبي الكريم محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. As we mentioned before, that niyyah or intention, that may be connected to takbir-e-tahrima without having any strange practice in between. The next thing is that near all school of jurisprudence it is must to specify the prayer. For example, that I intended to pray Faraz prayer of Zuhur, or Faraz of Asr, or Faraz of Maghrib, or Faraz of Isha, or the Faraz prayer of Fajr. That is specification. The Hanafite said, specification is best generally. Generally means apply to every type of prayer. Yani look, now we were praying two types of prayer, number one sunnah and number two faraz. So this is best to specifically mention the sunnah when we are praying sunnah, and then faraz when we do pray faraz. So generally this is recommended to specify the prayer concerned, but in case of faraz or wajib, specification is must. If you will say that I intended to pray two rakat prayer, two rakat, and you know that the farz of fajr is two rakat, but with such like intention, your prayer is not done because you did not specify the farz prayer. You did not specify the farz prayer. So in case of farz and wajib prayer, it is must to specify the prayer. In case of qada, the specification of day and time is must. For example, day before yesterday you missed zuhr prayer, and now you want to make it qada. So what you will say? The first prayer of the zuhr of day before yesterday, which I missed, I intended to pray the qada of my zuhr prayer, which I missed the day before yesterday. Or day before yesterday, it was Friday. So you will say what? Friday. You will say what? The zuhr prayer or the asr prayer, as the case may be, that I intended to make the qada of my zuhr or asr prayer of this Friday, past Friday. Got it? So in case of qada, the specification of day and time is must. But in case of ada, this is not must to mention the day and time. In case of ada, ada means you are praying in time. You are not missing. You are making what? Your prayer in time. So for today, when you were praying fajr, so look, that is enough that I intended to pray the faraz of this time. Yes, that you are going to pray, or the faraz of fajr. But the fajr of this time without specification of fajr, that's also okay, because you are referring to that present time. You are what? You are indicating to that present time. You mean what? Fajr. Because you know that you are in fajr, that is not zuhur, and you are praying the fajr prayer as well. Got it? So that's why we say that specification of day and time, specification of day and time in case of ada is not must. Is not must. So you can mention only this time, present time, the faraz of this present time. Got it? So today is Sunday? Yes. So you do not need to say that I intended to pray the further prayer of this Sunday. So that is Sunday. Or the further prayer of Fajr. As you will say, that's good. But if you did not say, and you will say, this present time, that is done. This present time, that is done. Got it? In case of Sunnah and Nafl, specification is best. Now you prayed your two Sunnah. Day two Sunnah, you can pray with the intention of only prayer. That I intended to pray two rakat prayer. So your Sunnah is done. But the best is to say two rakat Sunnah prayer. To say what? Surah Sunnah prayer. Then, if someone is alone, he may specify the type of farz or wajib. And if he is going to pray nafal, it could be done with by the intention of prayer only. So you do not need to mention two rakat nafal prayer. If you will say that I intend you to pray two rakat prayer, that is done. Your nafal is done. And if someone is an imam, then the only extra intention for him is to intend the imamat of woman. So his imama may include them. His imamat may include them. As we mentioned last Sunday. And if he is a muqtadi, muqtadi means standing behind imam. Then he needs an extra intention of iqtida, I-Q-T-I-D-A. If he did not make the intention of iqtida, the prayer behind imam is not okay. Iqtida means, yes, to mention by tongue or by heart behind this imam. What? That means iqtida. Intention of iqtida. That's much for whom? For muqtadi. By Congress. As I mentioned before, that as far as the case of Niyya is concerned, Niyya is the practice of heart. Yes, expression by tongue is permissible according to Imam Malik and recording according to other three Imams. If you have not written it, so just write it down. That intention or expression by tongue is permissible according to Imam Malik and that is recommended according to others. So that was according to whom? This detail? Abu Hanifa. According to Imam Malik. Specification is needed in Farz. Now look, we said that according to Abu Hanifa, specification generally is recommended. But that is must in Farz and Wajib prayer. That is must in Farz. But according to Imam Malik, specification is must in Farz. Witr, Eden, Rafi'i, Khusuf and Khusuf, Istisqa, I-S-T-I-S-Q-A, Istisqa, and sunnah of fajr. Sunnah of zuhr, that is done with the intention of holy prayer. Yes. Sunnah of maghrib or isha is done with the intention of only prayer, without specification of sunnah. But sunnah of fajr is more than sunnah. So that's why I say it must be mentioned or specified. Then ada could be done with the intention of qada and vice versa. Ada could be done with the intention of qada and vice versa. If he knows that these two words are used in the meaning of other. These two words are used in the meaning of other. Because the Arab says, Qadaytu Zainahu. Qadaytu. I did qada of his loan. Qada means ada. Qada means ada. So if he knows that qada means ada and ada means qada. For example, you missed the prayer day before yesterday and now you want to make it qada and you say, I intended to do ada of the zuhr prayer of day before yesterday. So you use the word ada, but you do mean by that ada what? Qada. Got it? So what you read? What you wrote? That ada and qada both could be used in the meaning of each other if he knows that use. If he knows that use. The only exception according to Imam Malik regarding specification of prayer is if someone joined an imam, he came, look, that was Friday, Zuhr time. He came, the imam was standing and people are behind him. Imam was standing and people are behind him. So what he did, look at me. He made the intention of Friday prayer. That I intended to pray the Friday prayer. Yes. At this present time, behind this imam. Allahu Akbar. Yes. But when the job was done, so he came to know that imam was not praying Friday. He was praying Zuhr. He was not praying Friday. He was praying Zuhr. So in this regard, his prayer is okay. But vice versa is not okay. You should write it. If he joined an imam Friday, Zuhr time, with the intention of Friday prayer, and later on he came to know that this was not Friday prayer, he was praying Zuhr prayer. So his prayer is okay. But vice versa, that is not. Imam was praying Friday and he made the intention of what? Zuhr. Later on he came to know that, oh, he was praying Friday prayer. He was not praying Zuhr prayer. So his prayer is not okay. Got it or not it? Yes. Yeah. That's why according to Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, for those who are not bound to pray Zuhr, who are not bound to pray Friday, who are not bound to pray, because there are conditions, as we will talk about that in detail, that for Friday prayer there are certain conditions according to different imams. Regarding, yes, the strict case is that of Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, regarding Friday prayer, because he says that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith, لا تقام الجمعة إلا في مصر. لَا تُقَامُ الْجُمْعَةُ إِلَّا فِي مِصْرٍ. So then you have to define the Misr. That there is no Jum'a prayer but only in city. There is no Jum'a prayer but only in city. Now what is city? So you have to go to the dictionary. So they have defined that lahu amirun wa qadim yunafidh al ahkam wal hudud. Yes, their city Islamically is their place which has a mayor. What? A mayor, and it has a judge who implements the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala there. So if you will look to the basic definition of Misr and the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so there is no Friday prayer all over the world. Yes? Because you do not see any city like this where, yes, partially they implement the rules of Allah, but as a whole, they do not. In certain Muslim countries, yes, on civil side, they have the Islamic rules. On civil side, they have the Islamic rules. But our criminal side, and somebody asked me, they have implemented. They have implemented the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on civil side. Why they do not implement on criminal side? So I said, because the rulers themselves, they are criminals. Brother Umar, yes, do you agree? So they don't want to be. Yes. Got it or not? This was a good answer or a bad? This was a very good answer. Got it? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تقام الجمعة إلا في مصر. So therefore Abu Hanifa rahimahullah says, say it on Friday. Those who are not bound to pray Friday, they should pray individually. They may not make a jama'ah. So nobody may be confused that, oh, Jummah is praying behind this imam, my Jummah prayer, Allah Akbar. God is not it. Yes. But according to Imam Malik, rahimahullah, if the imam is praying Zuhr on Friday, and somebody joined him with the intention of Friday prayer, so his prayer is okay. His prayer is okay. But vice versa, that's not okay. Other way around, that's not okay. Got it? Then, intention of infirad and iqtida. There are three words. Look at me. Number one, infirad. Infirad means praying individually. I-N-F-I-R-A-D. Infirad. Iqtida means praying behind imam. And the third word is imamat. And you know. You know what it means? Yes, leading. So, in case of infirad and iqtida, the intention is must. But in case of imamat, it is not must for imam to make the intention of imamat, according to Imam Malik. And that's why if somebody is praying his own prayer and you join him, so automatically he became imam, even though he never made the intention of imamat. He was praying his own prayer. You join him in second rakat or third rakat, so automatically he become what? Imamat. While he never made his intention of imamat. Yes, in Friday, that is must. Because imam is a condition for Friday. You should write. Imam is a condition for Friday. For Zuhr, that's not a condition. Is it? You can pray individually. But can you pray your Friday prayer individually? Say, no. In Eden, can you pray individually? No, there is no individual Eid prayer. Got it? In Kusuf and Khusuf, can you pray individually according to Imam Malik? No. According to Imam Malik? No. Got it? Or, two prayer in case of need and necessity in the time of one of them, which is called Jama Bain Salatain. Which is called Jama Bain Salatain. Praying two prayers combinedly or jointly in the time of one, as we do there in Muzdalifah. Or we do in Arafat when we are there behind the Imam of Hajj. Because there's also a disputed case that combining together Zuhr and Asr in Arafat, that is for everyone. So three Imam said that that is because of Arafat. That is because of us? Because of Arafat. Abu Hanifa said, rahimahullah, that is because of Arafat being in Hajj behind the Imam of Hajj. Yes, now if you will memorize this, so that will be easy to understand. For it, what words are you? Because you are now the Imam of Hajj. Yes, look, and then you will apply, you will explain. That according to three Imams, joining together, Zuhr and Asr at Arafat. That is because of Arafat. That's because of Arafat. Abu Hanifa says, that is because of Arafat being in Hajj behind the Imam of Hajj. You know what I'm saying? So somebody who is on that very day, even though he's a Hajj, but he is not yet arrived in Arafat, he is somewhere in Mina or Muzdalifa or in Mecca even, can he join together these two prayers? Got it? Number one. Number two, somebody who is in Arafat, but he is not a Hajj. He is not performing Hajj. Yes, a local guy. Who? A local guy. So can he join together? Zuhr and prayer. And number three, someone is in Arafat and he is in Hajj, but he is not praying those prayers behind the Imam of Hajj. Not behind Imam. What do you say? No. And who is the Imam of Hajj? No. Sheikh Abdulaziz. Sheikh Abdullah. Who? Sheikh Abdullah. He is also bin Baz, but he is not the brother of Abdulaziz bin Baz. Yes. His father Baz is somebody else. Yes. And that is a coincidence that Sheikh Abdulaziz bin Baz, rahimahullah, he was a blind and Sheikh Abdullah is also a blind. Yes. But Ya Subhanallah, he and this guy both, they are just like computers. Yes. Their memory is very strong. Yes. Whenever a question is asked, so I met this Sheikh Abdullah only once, but Sheikh Abdulaziz I met a few times. Yes. And I had sitting with him and the discussion and debate with him. Yes. He was a very nice man. This one is also a nice man, but I don't know him that much. But Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has given him that status, so it means that he's a nice man. He's right to Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah, he was a computer. Yes, whenever somebody asked him a question, he used to sit in the... Have you seen him? Yes. So Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah, he used to sit there and doing like this. Because the blind people, mostly they are doing like this. So he was sitting in chair and he was doing like this. And the people used to ask a question. Yes. And he said, فَكِيهَا ذِي الْمُنَاسَبَةِ فدروا أحمد بن حنبل عن جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله تعالى عنه أما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أفهم so then another one and another عالم was sitting beside him. They say somebody asked a question like this, so he says Sheikh عبد الرحمن الدارمي in his sunan narrated a hadith from معاوية بن أبي سفيان رضي الله تعالى عنه the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said so and so. He was just a computer. And somebody told me that same is the case of this Sheikh Abdullah. But I have never come across him in such a situation. So anyhow. Yes. Got it or not it? So in Friday prayer? In joining two prayers together when it is needed. When it is needed. And that is needed when somebody is traveling. It has conditions. According to different Imam, there are different conditions. Because according to Imam Malik, rahimahullah, if you have not prayed your zuhur yet, and you are starting your traveling and your journey before Asr, you want to start your journey before Asr. So only in such like case you can combine together your Zuhr and prayer, your Zuhr and Asr. Yes, it is called Jama Bain As-Salatain. But we the Hanafiya, as you know, that we don't make that. We do only Al-Jama Al-Suri because of the Hadith of Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala an, that kunna na'uddu Al-Jama Bain As-Salatain min Al-Kabair. That we use to think about Jama between two prayers, yes, min Al-Kabair from major sins. And Abu Hanifa said, rahimahullah, see, it doesn't make sense. According to him, he says that it doesn't make sense. Why? Number one, Ibn Abbas, who narrates the Jama'a Bain As-Salatain, this is the only riwayah. That the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jama'a Bain As-Salatain biduni uzrin, or Jama'a Bain As-Salatain, khinama kana fi safarin. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he combined and joined together two prayers in the time of one. In the time of? One, when he was traveling. So Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah says, that was not a routine practice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, it would have been related by hundreds of sahaba. Got it? So it means that he did it once. So that would be his special case. that could be what? Yes, exceptional case of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, number one. And number two, that is khabar-e-wahid. This hadith is khabar-e-wahid. And khabar-e-wahid cannot overrule the text of Quran. Are a mutawatir factor. And the text of Quran is inna salata kanat al-mu'mineen kitab al-mawfuta. That prayer is farz in its specific time. So that is the ayah of Quran. And the riwayah of Ibn Abbas is what? Say, khabar-e-wahid. So khabar-e-wahid cannot overrule Holy Quran. Got it? That's number two. And number three, if that was the case, that when you are traveling, so you can combine together Zuhur and Asr, or you can combine together Maghrib and Isha. If that was the case or would have been the case, so there was no need of specifically mentioning that Jama in Muzdalifah and Arafat. Because mostly Hajis, they are on Safar. They are on traveling. Why Prophet specifically he mentioned Jama of two prayer in Arafat and Jama of two prayer in Muzdalifah? Yes, there was no need. This routine practice when you are traveling, so you are praying together. Got it? So that's how these Ayyamah Rahimahullah they debate and discuss. Yes, Asr, that is according to Abu Hanifa Rahimahullah. Asr is because of traveling. So that's why the local guy, even though if he is in Hajj, he cannot make Asr. Ibn Rushd al-Qurtubi. Ibn Rushd, I-B-N-I. And other word is Rushd, R-U-S-H, comma, D, Ibn Rushd. Al-Qurtubi, he was from Cordova. From where? Cordova, from Spain. And he is a well-known imam, yes, of Fiqh al-Malik. Because that part of the world means Marrakesh, Al-Jazair, they do follow whom? Imam Malik, Rahmat, Libya, Tunis, all of them, they are following whom? Imam Malik Ramatullahi Alayhi, and Spain was close to them. Spain was close to them. Abdurrahman al-Dakhil himself, Abdurrahman al-Dakhil himself, he was the follower of Imam Malik. Got it? So anyhow, we talked about Abdurrahman al-Dakhil there. He was the only Bani Umayyah who ran away and established his rule there in Spain. So anyhow, that's why that madhab got fame there in that area. Imam Malik, rahmatullahi alayhi. So anyhow, Ibn Rushd al-Qurtubi, he is from Cordova, from Spain, and he has written a few books. He has written a tafsir. And he has written a very famous book in fiqh of Imam Malik, Brother Omar, Bidayatul Mujtahid wa Nihayatul Muqtasid. The book is named what? Bidayatul Mujtahid wa Nihayatul Muqtasid. That is in fiqh of Imam Malik written by Imam Ibn Rushd. And Imam Ibn Rushd, he was a physician as well. He was not only a sheikh of Masjid. He was also a physician. Ibn Rushd, Imam Ibn Rushd. In philosophy, he has written a famous book, Hazar Brahmi, that in English. Yes. That's a very famous book in what? So Ibn Rushd says that is much for Imam to make the intention of Imamat in case of Janaza also. Because Janaza could not be prayed individually. Janaza could not be prayed individually. So that's why that is much for Imam to make the intention of Salati Janaza. So in all these cases, if an imam missed the intention of imama, his prayer is void. His prayer is void. In what case? In Friday prayer, number two. Say, in his prayer, number three, in janaza. But in case of Jama, in case of, not Juma, in case of Jama means joining together two prayers. In case of Jama, The first one is okay. The second prayer is wise if he has not made the intention of Imamat. This is right. The first prayer, that's okay. The second one is wise. Because for the first one, the niyat of Imamah was not must because that's the time of prayer. That is what? That's the time of prayer. So he can pray that with the intention of present time. And he can pray that without the intention of Imamah. But joining together, according to Imam Malik, especially in case of rain, especially what? In case of rain, if it is raining,
yes,
and we know that, oh, not now, at that time, that there is a lot of mud and it is raining, that will be difficult for people to pray Maghrib, go back home from Far Isha. Go back home from Far Isha. So that's why they used to pray Maghrib and Isha both at the time of Maghrib. Is Ahmad? Maghrib. But for their prayer, individual cannot do that. Their jama could be done only because if he is praying individually, so why he is praying it before time in masjid? He can do the same at home. Yeah, just pray Maghrib and go back home and individual prayer you can pray there at home at Isha time. Yes, but if you want to pray the same with Imamah, but people cannot come easily when that is raining. Yes, so jama according to Imam Malik is allowed. Jama according to Imam Malik in case of rain is allowed. But that is allowed only if the Imamah is taking place. You know what I'm saying? So that's why the intention of Imamah in such a case is a must according to Imam Malik. Now you got it? How he is putting these in case, what they call the beast, or the pawns. Yes. How this Imam is putting pawns in his place, proper place. Got it? Rahimahullah. Every one of them must be given but 1 billion PhDs. Yes, because regarding every single issue, they have done a PhD. So, Ramah, is it the case? Regarding every single issue? Yes, subhanAllah, they have made research. So, in such like case, if he did not make the intention of Imamah, the first prayer is okay. Because that is in its own time. Yes, and Imamah is not a must for prayer in its own time. That is Sunnah. That's what? Sunnah. But in case of rain, Imamah is a must. So that's why the niyat of Imamah is also must. Got it? In case of Salatul Khawf, Salatul Khawf, prayer in fear, prayer. And fear is only that of battle, not fear of a wild beast. No, fear of battle in the battlefield. And as we mentioned, as an example, yet we will give you later on, but Salatul Khawf is, look, that battle is going on. Battle is going on. And Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, when he is not going to recommend more than one imamat in one place, in one time. He said, people must join the proper imamat, the proper jama'ah. Why they are coming in Guru Sannyak in jama'ah? That is against the basic philosophy of imamat. What is the basic philosophy of imamat and jama'ah? Unity. What? Unity to be united and unified as one. So if they are coming in groups, so where is the philosophy? So according to Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, oh, thanks to Imam Al-Lutuf, rahimahullah, that he gave his fatwa. Otherwise, the Hanafiya, you were not allowed to make the second jama'ah. Yes, if somebody has joined the jama'ah, that is done. If they are coming after that, just pray individually. Yes, but still, Abu Yusuf, rahimahullah, he is a student of whom? Imam Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah. So he allowed that, but he said that change the shape of that imamah. Change the shape of the second imamah. So the first imamah, that was in its proper place, in mihrab. So the second one may not be here. That should be somewhere in a corner. Number one, for the first one, they made iqamah. For the first one, they made iqamah. For the second one, there is no iqamah. Because iqamah is actually calling towards the recommended practice. And the second imamah is not a recommended practice. He said the second jama'ah is not recommended while you are calling people. You are encouraging their laziness. said, okay, who cares? Yes, we'll go late and we'll make another jama'ah. Have you got it? So anyhow, yes, subhanallah. And at that time, in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes, are in the time of Muslim leaders, in the time of Khulafa Rashidin, like Khalid ibn Walid, radiyallahu ta'ala an, Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, radiyallahu ta'ala an, Amr ibn al-As, radiyallahu ta'ala an, people were in that much big love with their leader. People were in that much big love with their leader and with their general, that everybody wanted to pray behind their leader. Yes, everybody did not want to pray only, or to pray behind an imam, not to pray behind their leader, under the leadership of whom he is going to fight for the sake of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, one imam can lead only one prayer, not two. Can somebody lead two prayers, one over here and one in temple? You know what I'm saying? God is not it. Because for him, the first one is fard, but the second one is nafal. Yes, ولا يصح اقتداء المفترض المتنفلين. Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah says that there is no اقتداء of someone who is praying first behind someone who is praying nafal. Because the category of nafal is lower than what? Farz. So the Imam is praying the lowest category of prayer and the muqtadi is the highest category. Yes, it doesn't make sense. You know what I'm saying? So one Imam can lead only one prayer in one time, and everybody wants to pray behind him. But the battle is going on. If all of them, they will stand, as it was the case. It was the case that Sahaba Rizwanullah Alayhim Ajma'in, they were praying behind Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in battlefield, Salatul Kufar. Yes? And then the Kufar and disbelief, oh, we missed the opportunity. Yes, they have put their weapons on ground, and they were praying. We should have attacked them at that time. They were unable to retaliate because they were in prayer. So some other said, oh, another prayer is coming. Another prayer of Asr. And that is much more precious to them than everything all over the world. Yes, Hafiz wa salawati. Was salat al-wusta, that is salat al-wusta, salat al-asr. And they are engulfed in their prayer. And Prophet said, man fatah salat al-asr. فَكَنَّمَا وَتَرَ أَهْلُهُ وَمَالُهُ Whosoever missed Salatul Asr, so he is in debt with big loss, is his family and his belongings, all of them, they got burnt. So it means much more precious thing. So they will pray there. At this time, they will attack them. Yes? So before that, Jibreel Amin came. Yes? And he told Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that's here in Holy Quran. Yes? In Surah Al-Ma'idah. فَلْتَقُمْ طَائِفَةٌ فَلْيَأْخُذُوا أَسْلِحَتَهُمْ That one group should stand behind you and they should have their light weapon with them, like a pistol or like a sword, but not a shaka, yes, or kilo yak, or anti-aircraft. They cannot play, having their finger missile with them, they cannot play in such like situation. Yes, that is known only to us, not to you people. You have never seen it. Yes. Professor, have you seen all these things? Yes. Because you never got involved in fight against Russians. Yes. But in our area? Yes. The kids who were kids at that time, now they are married and they have kids. But when fight against and jihad against Russians was going on, so they know all these things. Yes. That's what is tinder. What is cut? What is the koyak? What is the nayak? What is the awan? Yes? What is interior trap? Yes? In our area, we used to challenge with the Hawa Tema. Interior trap is what? With the Hawa Tema. In our Persian language, we used to call it what? With the Hawa Tema. So, what is with the Hawa Tema? So, anyhow, such like big things, nobody can carry, can pray it. But a small sister and a sword, he can carry and pray. It's what? Got it? And another group, they should have their heavy weapon facing the enemy. So they may not attack. Now, the proper case of this, let's call Salat-e Khawf. You can write the word. Salat-e Khawf, F-A-L-A-T, -I-K-H-A-U-F. So that's it. Khawf. Khawf means fear. Yeah. So now the imam will start the prayer. And mostly when better is going on, so people are traveling, so that's why mostly they are praying what? Qasr. They are praying what? Qasr. So the imam lead one group in one rakat. Then their group come to the base, and the other group, they go forth. And they join imam in the second rakat. The second group join imam in the second rakat. Now, after two rakat, imam has to make salam because his salat is completed. So now this second group, they will stand up and they will pray. The missed rakat is the salati masbuk. Let's call salat of whom? Masbuk. Masbuk is one who missed the first part of prayer with imam. Like as usually happened to us. When he comes, imam is in second or third rakat, so he is called what? Masbuk. Got it? When they complete their prayer, so then the first group, they come forth. They have prayed already one rakat, but still they have another one to pray. Yes? So they will complete their prayer. Their salat is called Salatul Lahiq. L-A-H-I-Q. Lahiq. The one who missed the last part of his salat with imam. Masbuk missed the first part. And Lahiq missed the last part. But now, different to Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, in the case of Masbuk and Lahiq, is that Masbuk is to pray as he is praying individually. Masbuk has to pray the first part of his prayer. When we stand up after that, Imam made the salam. So what we do? We recite, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Rahman, Rahim, Arikim, Jini, Akram, Udiya, Kanu, Sahin. Yes or not? We do. Yes. But Lahiq, he has to stand only as somebody is standing behind Imam. This is right. And back it. That Masbuk has to pray his missed part of Salat as someone who is praying individually. But Lahiq, he has to pray the missed part of his Salat, which is the last part. The missed part of his Salat, like one who is praying behind Imam. This is only a difference according to Abu Hanifa, not according to others. Because according to others, that is make difference. Especially according to Ahmad ibn Hanbal and Imam Shafi, rahimahullah, especially in Salati Sirri. Especially in what? In Salati Sirri, not Jahri. Because in Salati Jahri, as we mentioned, that Ahmad ibn Hanbal does not say for recitation. Ahmad ibn Hanbal, he does not say for recitation. But in Salati Sirri, or if he is standing behind an imam, that he cannot listen to the imam. You know what I'm saying? So he has to recite what? Suratul Fatiha. Yes, we said what? Surat al-Fatiha. But doesn't make difference. Huh? Makes sense in Sirri and Jari. If in Sirri, he must. But in Jari, yes, he may not. According to whom? No, no. According to Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Why you get confused? This is a very complicated subject. Kiraat Khalf al-Imam. When we will approach it, so we will talk in detail. But we start in detail in Ramadan, I give you almost a full risala. You know what I'm saying? Yes, he was not there. Unfortunately. Yes. Abdul, you wrote it? Yes. I think that Bilal completed that he put it on the internet or not. Huh? No. That's not on the internet. So anyhow, these disputed or complicated issues, yes, we spoke in detail about all these things. Like when the khutbah is going on and people are coming in front to rakat tahiyyatul masjid. So we talked in detail about that. That's according to whom? Only according to Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahmatullahi alayhi and ahlul zawahir. And that's because of the hadith of Tariq al-Ghitfani, which is, once again, the khabari wahid. So far as the Hanafiya, the easy case is, brother, that's the khabari wahid. Yes, and that's the case of one Sahabi, Tariq al-Ghitfani. And Prophet ﷺ told him twice. If that would have been the case, he was in no need of telling him. Yes. So why he said it? So he mentioned here. Got it? So anyhow. Because not to Ahmad and Ahmad, according to Imam Malik. Yes. People are doing it and they don't know who said it. And that according to Imam Malik, Hamadullah Ali, he said that Juma time, they start with Duha. It was the Salat is Duha. Now the sun is bright, so if people have any excuse, they can pray their Juma now. Yes. Got it? But that's only for little, according to Imam Malik, Rahmahullah, in certain circumstances. In certain circumstances, according to other three Imams, وَوَقْتُ صَلَاةِ الْجُمُعَةِهِ صَلَاةُ الظُّهُرِ. That's a general rule. That the time for Salat al-Jum'ah is the time of Zuhur. So anyhow, what I was saying? Huh? So lahiq. He is considered as he is still behind Imam. Okay? And in Hanafi school as your student, somebody is standing behind Imam, he is not going to recite anything. Neither Surah al-Fatiha, nor any other surah. So what he will do? He will come, or their group will come, and they will be standing like this. Look. As you are standing behind Imam. Allah. Because behind Imam, all these we say. Yes or not? But we do not recite neither Surah Al-Fatiha nor any other surah. Got it? Or not it? Yes. The Shafi'i said that niyat is the action of heart, but expression is recommended before takbir. But in case of janaza, qaza, and pledge. In case of janaza, qaza, and what? Pledge. And for example, Abid Sahib gave a pledge to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. What he said? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if from this business I will earn $1 million, so I will pray 2 rakat nafala. Yes. Huh? Mannat, yes. But it's called Nazar. It's called what? Nazar. N-A-Z, R. Nazar is play. And Prophet said, don't make Nazar. Don't make Nazar. Whatever you want, just do it without Nazar. Whatever good you want. Why you are making a Nafal Ibadah as a wajib for yourself? Because if you express this, such another word, so the same Nafal practice will become wajib. Then you are bound to do that. Yeah? And for example, if professor said that if I will never get class at night time not to miss my tafsir in this semester. Yeah? If I will never get my classes in Mission College in this semester, so I may not my tafsir. So I will arrange every Monday pizza for my classmates. Yes. So a professor wants to do it without making that nazar, he can do that. But if he pledges like this, then he is bound. Got it or not it? Because words are words. We speak, we do not think of our words. But words, kulla nafsin bima kasabat rahin. Yes. Got it? Then a promise is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for doing something good. If you intend, well, just do it according to your intention. Don't make yourself bound. Yes? And especially, nazar for spending money. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, inna nazra, لا يرد من القضاء شيئا وإنما يخرج به من البخيل أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. سبحان الله. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, if somebody gave a pledge to Allah, that, oh Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will get rid of this coat appearing. Yes? If I will get rid of this coat appearing, or if I will get the court decision in my favor, so I will spend $1,000 for your sacred cause giving it to poor. That's a pledge. That's what? Pledge. So if the job is done, he must do that. See? Must. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, that the decree was the same decree without pledge as well, because that is decided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already. لَا يَرَدُّ مِنَ الْقَدَرِ شَيْئًا أو مِنَ الْقَدَرِ شَيْئًا. The decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could not be rejected by doing what? Nazar. By doing? Nazar. But the guy did it, and decree came in the same way. So Rasulullah said, إِنَّمَا يَخْرُجُ مِنَ الْبَخِيلِ. The guy himself is a miser guy. So in such a way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bringing out some money from the pocket of Bakir. Yes or not? Yes. So in case of janaza, qaza, nazar, or repeating a prayer, if it has become white, sometimes we pray, yes, and after prayer, we come to know that our prayer is what? Why? Because I was not with Guru. So if you prayed your prayer, and later on you came to know, oh, I prayed, but I was not with wudu. I had, so what you will do? You will make wudu and you will repeat your prayer, because your prayer is not done. Your prayer is not done. Got it? Or you missed a wajib in your prayer, where you were supposed to make the salah. Where you were supposed to what? To make the salah, but you didn't. But you, and you made salam. And after this, I was supposed to make the dua, but I couldn't. So what you will do, as long as the time is still there, you have to repeat it. Yes. You have to what? To repeat it. So in case of janaza, qaza, nazar, and repeating a prayer, he must make intention. And specify it. Also, according to Imam Shafi, rahimahullah, sunnah could be prayed with the intention of only prayer, without specifying sunnah, that I intend to pray two rakat, without mentioning to pray two rakat, sunnah. No, to pray two rakat, so sunnah is done. But, not two types of sunnah. It needs a specification. Number one, sunnatul waqt. You should write it in such a way. Sunnatul waqt, S-U-N-N-A-T-U-L dash W-A-Q comma T. Sunnatul waqt. And number two, sunnatul sabab, S-U-N-N-A-T-U-S dash S-A-B-A-B. Sunnatul sabab. Sabab means reason. Sabab means. So sunnatul waqt means like the sunnah of zuhur. Yes. That is sunnah because of time. That is sunnah what? Because of time. Like sunnah of isha. That is sunnah because of time. And sunnatul sabab like khusuf and kusuf. Sun eclipse and moon eclipse. Why we pray it? There is a reason. So that is called sunnatul sabab. So Imam Shafi says that sunnatul waqt and sunnatul sabab needs a specification in intention. It needs, yes, to be specified for intention. Got or not? But for nafal, that is not must. For nafal, that is not must to specify. Yes. So you can say, turakat, prayer. Turakat, prayer. So your nafal is done. Your nafal is done. Then this is also recommended to make intention for Allah as we say, for the sake of Allah. He said intention what? for sake of Allah. To make intention for Allah. Number two, making intention to face Qibla. As we say, mutawajjihan ila jihatil Kaaba al-Musharrafa. Facing the Holy Kaaba. So this is recommended. And the number of rakat to be mentioned, that is also recommended, not a must. So now look, we prayed Salat al-Fajr. So how many rakat of Salat al-Fajr is? Two. Salat is two. So this is recommended to say that I intended to pray two rakat Farz of Fajr. Two rakat Farz of Fajr. But if you do not mention the number, that I intended to pray this Farz of Fajr. What is done? Because that is known. That it is not three, but yesterday it was three and today it's five and tomorrow it will be seven. That is known. That is what? Two rakat. Got it? Also, the intention for Ada and Sada is must. That you are praying Ada or you are praying Sada. But if somebody made a mistake in Ada or Sada, he made a mistake in Ada or Sada, his prayer is done. How? Look, Brother Parvez woke up because he came late at night and he did not have the watch. Yes. That the time for Fajr is over or not, because it was cloudy or it was raining. It was raining and it was cloudy. So he couldn't know that the time for prayer is over or still we have it. So he thought that time is over. Yes, and the sun is shining, but this is cloudy. I couldn't see. So that's why he made the intention of Qaza of Fajr. He made what? And he prayed it. And the moment he prayed it, yes, so certainly the clouds were gone. And he came to know, oh, still the sun is not rising yet. You know, so does he need to repeat it? No, his salat is done. You got it? You should write it, otherwise you cannot apply it. Or other way around. Yes, he woke up. It was cloudy. Yes, it was not clear. Whether the time is gone or still that is. But he said, there is time still, because this is dark. This what? This is dark. So he prayed his Fajr with the intention of Ada. He prayed his Fajr with the intention of Ada. And the moment he made Salam, oh, sun was almost here. So it means that he prayed his Fajr after time. You know what I'm saying? And he made it with the intention of what? Qaza. And he was supposed to make it Qaza. So Salat is done. You should write it. That's what he said. That's what he said. If he didn't know that, why he made Qaza and Qaza. If he said that still that is fine. Still. There is time. So he made the intention of Ada. But he found out, oh, time was over long, long ago. Because time is low, now that is here. So his salat is done. Got it? Because as we know, that literally Ada means Sada and Sada means Ada. Got it? But according to Imam Shafi Ahmadullah Ali for Qada, he can make the intention of Qada only without mentioning the time and date, without mentioning the date or the day. Now look, there is another case, and you should keep in mind that one is called Qada Ussala. And the second one is called Qada ul-Umri. Qada ul-Sala انقضاء العمر. قضاء الصلاة means that you missed a prayer, one, two or three, and you want to make it. You want to do it قضاء. You want to do it قضاء. So in such like case, you have to mention the day and time. The Zuhr of such and such day. Zuhr of such and such day. But somebody, he missed a lot of prayer. Yes, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him now, and he became a commercial Muslim, and he wants to make the qaza of all those prayers. He wants to make the qaza of all those prayers. According to all four schools of jurisprudence, their type of qaza is allowed and permissible. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him. You should write it. That's called qaza ul-umri. That's called what? Qaza ul-umri. But the Salafis of nowadays, they do not say so. They say there is no qaza. I should say astaghfirullah. He should say what? Oh, brother, it doesn't make sense. If somebody missed one salat or two salat. So you say because of hadith that he has to make qada. So if he has missed more than that, so now he is king. He has become a king because he missed more than two, three. Does it make sense? Yes. He is much more bound to make it. But how he will? Because he doesn't know neither the day nor the day. Yes. Hundreds of prayers. So what he will do? According to Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, and Ahmad ibn Hanbal, he must make the intention of Zuhr prayer. If he is making qaza of Zuhr, any Zuhr. Qaza of Zuhr? Any Zuhr. So what he will say? I intended to pray the qaza of my Zuhr prayer which I missed. Allahu Akbar. He did it. I intended to make the qaza of my salat of Zuhr which I have missed. Allahu Akbar. Yes, then I intended to pray the qada of salat al-zohr which I have missed. Allahu Akbar. Got it? And pray. But Abu Hanifa says, rahimahullah, is bound to say, I intended to make the qada of the first zohr which I missed. The qada of what? You should write it. First zohr which I missed. So in his lifetime, whatever was the first zohr which he missed, that qada will be for that one. It has the column, so it will go to that column, like computerized system. Yes, you click on the first zohr, so it will go to that column. That's for 1976. You know what I'm saying? Huh, professor? If you know the date and the time, that is good. We are talking about qaza al-umri, where the day is not known to you. Even the year you do not know. In my lifetime, I have missed lot of prayers. So in such a case, Abu Hanifa rahimahullah says that he must mention that the first zuhur which I missed, the first maghrib which I missed. Now, when you prayed one zuhur, so whatever was the first on your record regarding missing, so that zuhur will go to that column. Yes. Now that is done. Now you are going to mention another zuhur. So say, the first zuhur. So whatever will be in order. Got it? So furthermore, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Salatu wassalamu ala Rasulina Muhammad wa ala Sahabi al-Ma'ilna wa Rabbana Muhammad al-Quran, Zimna wa Sallam al-Quran, Ma'ana Fina, 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 This is good or not? Brother Omar, what do you think about these fuqaha? Huh? 100. Yeah, that's